right. So, anyway, one thing I noticed about, you know, doing all this stuff is that, you know, a lot of people are wondering, and they're wondering about how to do stuff, and, that curiosity is kind of, isn't it inevitably leading them to pay for stuff, you know? And it's just a matter of what you do with that kind of, what you've spent really, how you invest it, what you're going to do with your time, and how much more are you going to spend? Which companies are you kind of looking to and seeing what they're doing? Keeping an eye on changes, you know? Yeah. It's finding the time, you know, because I think the difference between you and I, me being me, and you being someone who's spending money, is when you spend a lot of money, not only are you going to want to spend more time with that thing to get your return for the worth that you thought you had when you paid for it, is part of the price that you pay for it as well, you know? It's not going to work without the time. So if time is worth as much money as what you spend, then this is the missing link that people aren't kind of talking about. They can't teach that, you know. It's basically how desperate are you to do something. And not desperate in a negative way, but what drives you, you know, what's going to push you to do this stuff. Because a lot of this stuff is you can do it and you can stumble across. I mean, I'm being really vague here, you know. Yeah. I don't know what to say really. It's kind of been out all day meeting nice people. I've just seen a lot of culture. You know, I just went out and people all doing their thing, desperate for people to hear their craft, you know, they do singing or spoken word, whatever it is they do, and they put a lot of effort into it. You know, it's just a shame that you're looking at me now and you can clearly say there's no effort whatsoever. I'm not trying to take you with my words and lead you down some kind of story, narrative that is going to come away from your own gaze onto me. You know, there's no secrets here. I don't even know why you're kind of looking for them secrets. It's like the message that I have for you here is very, very clear. It's like, just do it. Look at me, you know. You're probably thinking, this guy must be a right muppet or a right mug. Trust me, this is good. And the content, I really think you've got to experience it to know. So if you're looking for content, look for it. And then don't think that's the end of it. Because the chances are, if you came across that content, you know, it's the real deal as far as it gets, you know. But once you go, because the veil, this thinning of the veil is a very, very poignant point. And yeah, the veil is thinned, but it's never going to be able to, you're never going to be able to see through that veil, you know, until you actually know what's on the other side, until you've kind of got got some kind of synaptic memory on the other side of that inner circle, and even once you get into that inner circle and go inside, you know, in order to peel the layers of that onion to go down it, you're gonna have to earn, you're gonna have to pass certain things to just be to be let in. You know, the whole world's been took on board different kind of symbolic systems that have been used for ages, and you know, you're not gonna get in unless everybody give you the nod. It's very, very simple. And if you got the money, you can buy your way in. I'm finishing there anyway. See you later.